And here is the Writer's Almanac for Friday. It's the 9th of April, 2021. It was on this day, 1859, a 23-year-old gentleman named Samuel Clemens received his steamboat license. He had paid a river pilot named Horace Bixby $500 to take him on as an apprentice. He spent 2 years as a cub pilot traveling up and down the Mississippi before he got his license, 1859. Unfortunately, the Civil War cut short his career as a pilot. April 1861, all traffic stopped on the Mississippi River, but he used his experiences in his great book, Life on the Mississippi. It was on this day, 1865, Robert E. Lee surrendered to Ulysses S. Grant, effectively ending the Civil War. They met at a house in Appomattox, Virginia, talked over terms. Lee asked Grant to write it down, which Grant did, and Lee accepted the terms on the spot. They shook hands, and Lee rode off to inform his men. In 1682, on this day, the French explorer de La Salle, Robert Cavelier Sieur de La Salle, discovered the mouth of the Mississippi River and claimed the land for France, naming the new territory La Louisiane. He had come with his 40 men all the way down from Canada. They'd come through Chicago and down the Fox River, the Illinois River, to the Mississippi. They came past Memphis, Tennessee, and finally arrived where the Mississippi empties into the Gulf of Mexico, near where Venice, Louisiana, is today. There was a grand ceremony, and De La Salle, wearing a gold-laced red cloak, planted a cross at the site. It's the birthday of Gregory Pincus, born in Woodbine, New Jersey, 1903, studied genetics, got his Ph.D. in zoology, and then about 1950, he met Margaret Sanger, who was the founder of Planned Parenthood, and who had been looking for years for an affordable birth control method for women. Pincus had already discovered that hormone injections could stop ovulation in animals. He did the science, and she got the money, and they developed an oral contraceptive, a combination of estrogen and progestin. Conducted trials in Puerto Rico, and the drug came out in 1960 under the brand name Enovid. As a result of years of exposure to laboratory chemicals, Pincus developed a rare blood disease and died a few years later. And it's the birthday of the songwriter Tom Lehrer, New York City, 1928, author of The Vatican Rag, Masochism Tango, Poisoning Pigeons in the Park. Very popular in the 50s and 60s, toured and then decided he didn't enjoy performing in front of audiences, what he called anonymous affection, and he retired to teach mathematics at the University of California, Santa Cruz. Here's a poem for today by Marie Howe entitled Questions. Did you know your mother? This morning, even before the light came, the birds started singing. Who were you then? I wrapped myself in the white sheet and stood on the top of the wooden stairs outside, the dawn slowly coming from the direction of the bay. Did she touch you? Was she an affectionate person? I called her name into the fold between night and day. I called it without expecting her to answer. A poem by Marie Howe, Questions, from her collection The Kingdom of Ordinary Time, published by W.W. Norton and used by permission here on The Writer's Almanac. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.